Hey, it's really cool to be here in the studio. Usually I do the thing from my place in Vegas, but it is cool to be here at the LA radio studio.
Oh my gosh, I'm so glad you brought this up. I almost forgot to mention that this very well could be the final episode of this podcast. We don't know. I mean, things are so up in the air now as court battles go. Gentrification has taken hold of the whole Portsakall area, which is this little shopping district that's been here for many decades, right on the coast, over right on the edge of the LA the LA Harbor, which is also the LA River. It's part, you know, that's the tributary. So most of this shopping area has been bulldozed and gone, and all that's left is our studio and Portsakall Restaurant, which the relationship is, it's the same owner essentially, and our executive producer Mike Stark is indelibly connected to this because
Mike!
He operates the LA radio studio here, and so we've been following the legal proceedings, Mike, and the last one was posted in a local newspaper saying, well, the restaurant must go, and if the restaurant must go, so must the studio.
Correct, but there is an appeal being filed, and as bureaucracies go, this is going to probably give us another month or so.
So we're going to leave inevitably at some point.
Yeah, yeah.
Can we leave on our own terms?
Yeah, we will leave on our own terms.
We don't have to do a David Koresh burn the place down kind of thing. We don't have to do that.
I have thought about leaving a camera in here for after the fact just to see what was going on.
So, Mike,
you got to rotundo this thing into oblivion.
Oh, There you go.
Nice.
Well, if we leave on our own terms, that means we can have a party.
We are going to have an on-air party. It'll last all day.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, Mike built an incredible facility here, and it's really unique in that it is not part of a radio group or a company. It is a radio studio, but it's not affiliated with a CBS or an Entercom or a Clear Channel or anything like that. And it's a place where you can come and create audio content. And what you did here was amazing, and I'm looking forward to seeing what happens next.
Well, the credit needs to go to my partner, Jamie Wilson, who will be on the show again soon to give us an update. But that's where the credit lies, and it really has meant a lot to me to have all you guys in the studio today.
Yeah, well, we talked Gonzo into driving in from Las Vegas by convincing him this was the last show in the studio.
No, but now there's a party, so I will come back
for that.
Pencil it in, June 29th.
Yeah. All right, good. It'll give you cancer, but just the same, you'll have fun doing it.
Wow.
June 29th.
That's 2 points.
All right, I've written down that date. That'll be a special show for sure. I just got an email from Kelly J.
Kelly.
It leads with, holy hell.
Sounds like Kelly.
Yeah.
Well, you know, we need more broads on the show. So.
Yeah, we didn't have any today.
Say again, Stu?
It's been a couple weeks.
Nothing. Not even for Pete.
All right. Well, that's about it. What did I skip? Most unusual kids' names? No. Let's see. Florida criminal.
The crematorium story.
Yeah, well, we missed a crematorium story. Yeah, we did miss that. What else? It's National Tap Dance Day.
Don't Fry Day.
Yeah, Don't Fry Day. Oh, the bra size that makes women the most happy. Quick, can you tell us what that bra size is? That's all right. We got 20 seconds.
Okay.
You're going to find it? This is a public service.
C-cup.
C-cup. All right, thank you. All right. Thanks to our executive producer, Mike Stark. Our music, our theme song is composed and performed by Russ Monson. For intern Ricky, for Stu Herrera, and for Gonzo Greg Spillane. Holy hell, what a show we had today.
Oh, yeah.
I'm Phil Hulett. This is Phil Hulett and Friends. Thanks for listening. Talk to you next time.